Coming up on Let It Rip Weekend, politics and sports collide after the NBA delivers a devastating blow to North Carolina. The league is moving the 2017 All-Star Game out of Charlotte because of the state's controversial bathroom law.
My heart is broken for my city and my state because of the reckless inaction of Governor McCrory.
In any decision I make, I pick common sense values to protect our children and our schools. Over money.
Will this influence the presidential race and future laws for the transgender community? But first, Hillary Clinton picks her running mate. Can Senator Tim Kaine be a better sidekick for Hillary Clinton than Mike Pence is for Donald Trump? Let It Rip Weekend starts right now.
Well, thank you for joining us on Let It Rip Weekend. I'm Charlie Langton.
And I'm Marielle Liu. Here with us this morning is political consultant Sam Riddle and conservative host for WAAM Radio, Theron X.
Sam Riddle, let me start with you. Hillary Clinton chose her running mate, Senator Tim Kaine of Virginia. Some people are saying that he brings some the Latino vote. He's a couple of key swing states. But Sam, he's also head of the Democratic Party. And now it seems that there's other things coming out with the Democratic Party that they favor candidates. Is he the best choice for Hillary?
Well, absolutely not. But what he is a manifestation of is the arrogance of the Democratic Party establishment, Charlie. Stop and think about it. This guy came into the seat in Virginia as former head of the Democratic National Committee. There's no one more establishment Hillary could have picked to rub Bernie Sanders' face in it than this particular selection. Hillary has a big problem. Donald Trump is smacking his quack lips right now.
Well, I don't think, Theron, you're going to disagree with that, are you?
Trump's going to take this away regardless of who she picks. She could have picked a communist like Elizabeth Warren, whatever, but I think Kaine adds some semblance of conservancy to her, but it's all perception. I mean, at one point, that gentleman was for the death penalty, which is a straight-up conservative point of view. I think anybody associated with her, regardless of who they are, is aiding and abetting a criminal, given the Clinton Foundation and all.
Well, he's from Virginia, which is a swing state. He also speaks Spanish from Florida, which they just introduced him there. So those two things alone could help Hillary.
That's an attempt to placate her. We're going to kill the coal industry and steal all your jobs, too.
He's never lost an election. He's popular with the people. His son's in the military.
What people?
He's popular. He's never lost an election.
Where? We're talking about the United States of America, not Virginia. We're not talking about the
hypocritical,
dictatorial DNC. Hillary has a big problem right now. You know, Mitt Romney only lost that election by 64 electoral votes. The states of Michigan in play. The state of Ohio in play. Pennsylvania in play.
Who would you
Wisconsin in play. I can tell you right now, Donald Trump's going to win Michigan, for example.
Hell yes.
What about his foreign policy experience? What about the fact that his son is in the military? Do you think that will play well with any voters?
Who cares?
You don't care.
That's not what this is about. I think it's great. I'm a military veteran. Mm-hmm. I served 4 years as a Vietnam War era veteran, 65 to the end of 68. My point is that right now the dynamics in this presidential race are out of whack from everything we've known historically. I've been a delegate to the Democratic Convention.
Mm-hmm.
I was representing Jerry Brown. Jerry Brown was Bernie Sanders before Bernie Sanders.
Sam, it seems like me, if you, I assume you identify more with the Democratic Party than the Republican Party, but I'm not so sure anymore. Talk like that is going to get Donald Trump elected. Do you want that?
No, my talk won't get him elected. What will get him elected is status quo politics of Hillary Clinton. In Michigan, for example, I can predict, you look at the right face of the Democratic convention delegates from Detroit right now. Most of them can't even walk from campus marshes to the riverfront. How in the hell are they going to get out of vote? They won't. You've got the same union handkerchief head leadership that will not be able to control white members of their union who are going to replicate what Ronald Reagan did with Reagan Democrats.
Did you say white members of the union?
Absolutely.
All right.
They're going to support Donald Trump. I'm telling you
so
they are.
So what? What's wrong with that? Who gives a damn if somebody's white or black? The bottom line is this, sir. The bottom line is this. Donald Trump is going to seal that border. Donald Trump's going to grow that military. Secretary. Donald Trump's going to say America first.
Donald Trump is going to exploit fear and hate in America. Donald Trump is going to exploit fear and hate, and Hillary's going to let him get away with it. But are you out of your mind? What you ought to do is sell bricks for the wall.
What you ought to do is educate yourself. You got a smart mouth. I've educated myself more than you. All right, hold on.
Why don't we say? Listen, I want to know more so about. We have a campaign ad from Hillary Clinton. I want to get your thoughts on this right here. Hillary Clinton now is starting to run this campaign ad, and well, let's just take a look at the ad. A couple minutes of it here, right here.
I love the old days. You know what they used to do to guys like that when they were in a place like this? They'd be carried out on a stretcher, folks.
And you can tell them to go themselves.
I could stand in the middle of Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody, and I wouldn't lose any voters, okay? It's like incredible.
When Mexico sends its people, they're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're rapists.
You know, you could see there was blood coming out of her eyes. Blood coming out of her, wherever.
You got to see this guy. Oh, I don't know what I said. Oh, I don't remember. He's going like, I don't remember.
Okay, so the message there, what? The children are watching. What do you think about that ad?
That's a very effective ad, don't you think, for Hillary Clinton?
It looks bad. The optics aren't good. That's right. But I got to tell you, nothing matters yet. It's all up, I'd say, October is when people start paying attention. And at that point, they're going to be paying attention more or less to, hey, you know, this economy really does suck. The fact that they've been in this administration telling us it's good, we know it's a straight-up lie. Half the strip malls are closed down, empty, for sale, for rent.
But the point is, if Donald Trump keeps up the rhetoric like we just saw and heard on that Hillary Clinton ad, that's not going to be good for
That's not his rhetoric, by the way. His rhetoric, you saw his speech at the convention, which he knocked it over.
Trump has a very powerful connect with the American body politic. He is not to be underestimated. Over a year ago, when I went to Birch Run in person to see Donald Trump, some of my good friends in Detroit said, Sam, we saw you on TV. Why are you at a Trump rally? I said, because Trump is no joke like mainstream media would have you believe. Donald Trump has a very solid base with the American body politic that will defy the logic of experts that know nothing.
Okay, so let's take a look at a Trump ad and see if that plays into what you said, Sam. Say Trump is no joke. This is the latest Donald Trump ad playing off Pokemon Go.
Well, more people play Pokemon than watch Fox 2.
So
my point is that, like, he's connecting with people that are going to vote that normally wouldn't vote.
Sam, I don't know about that, by the way.
Hillary Clinton right now has a big problem in terms of turning out young white voters. Guess who's going to be positioned to help her with that the most? Ironically, the first black president can turn out more young white voters than Hillary Clinton herself. Michelle Obama is going to have to pump up an extraordinary turnout from black Americans that aren't that sold on Hillary Clinton either in terms of the enthusiasm level.
Why are black people thrilled? She's going to get
95% all black votes, but 90% of 85 is not the same as 90% of 120.
We got the first Marxist president is what we got. The first president that actually hates America and is trying to make it something.
Oh, that's garbage. That's bull.
Now, here's the deal. Forget him. He's gone anyway. That clown's gone in 4 or 5 months. Here's the deal. Donald Trump is going to lay waste to this insane trade deal, the TPP, the Trans-Pacific Partnership, that's going to gut America even further. You like Bill Clinton's NAFTA, you're going to love TPP.
Preaching to the choir. You know, I was raised in Flint, Michigan, a city decimated not just by poison water, but by NAFTA. Hillary Clinton is burdened and has the bear the baggage of NAFTA, of the agreement you just said.
Hillary Clinton
was devastated more by GM moving out of Flint, and then refusing to use Flint water because they knew it was poison than anything that's occurred.
Because it happened during Obama's term?
No, that happened before Obama. That happened during the term of Bill Clinton, NAFTA. I mean, we have a situation NAFTA,
Let me ask you guys something. At what point do you get sick of people just walking across our border and coming in here and taking social services? At what point? I mean, your wallet gets lighter every day because people come in here and get free crap. At what point do you get sick of that?
About the time your lettuce goes up to $5 a head.
There's no country without a border. There's no country
we
without a border.
We have a border. What we also we got have no border.
But
a neo-fascist
that message
like
is resonating
yourself,
with people,
nonsense.
Though.
It's resonating because it's true. And this is propaganda when you say we have a border. We don't have a border. It's
they're exploiting hate, racism, fear, misogyny,
and that's the
as well
old,
as xenophobia.
Same old dog whistle, man.
No, it
same
isn't.
Old
no, it isn't.
All right, hold that thought.
Racism, you know what a female dog
Trump
is,
racism,
though.
Also, we're going to talk about the All-Star game. Apparently, it's moving out of Charlotte because of the bathroom law. We've got a lot more to come. And again, we want you to weigh in. Use the hashtag LetItRip. You may very well see your comments on the end of this show. Back in a moment.
Also coming up, politics has crept its way into sports once again. This time, it's in the NBA. 2017 All-Star Game, as we mentioned, will no longer be held in Charlotte. We will be right back. And welcome back. The 2017 NBA All-Star Game relocation will cost North Carolina about $100 million. The league moved the game from Charlotte because of the state's controversial bathroom law.
All right, join us again, Sam Riddle, Theron X. Let me ask Sam, the All-Star Game, well, I'm going to ask Theron this. The All-Star Game moving out, was that a good move to show support for the LGBT community?
All I know is when I was 15 years old, I would have loved to have been able to say I was a girl going to girls' bathroom. I would have milked that to the max. But the bottom line is
that's not happening. You know
this
is
absolutely stupid. It's just stupid. I mean, I don't care where people go to the bathroom. I personally don't. Here's the cure to that: is stalls. You know. But the bottom line is this has all been politicized over. I call it the homosexual mafia. I have nothing against gay people. I love gay people. I love all people. But it's just been ginned up where a small percentage of hardcore people are totally trashing our lives about whether we can buy something in this state or.
So the NBA should have stayed put and not succumbed to the political pressures?
Well, you got to understand, it's the players themselves that were speaking up. NBA players that were exerting leverage to ensure that human rights go to everyone. You know, when we look at it, you know, bigotry anywhere is a threat to balling everywhere. Now think about that a second.
Oh, that's
bigotry anywhere is a threat to balding everywhere. I tweeted that and got a few good responses on it. The point is that if you are an NBA player and you begin to exert leverage on the ownership as to whether or not you may even play, there may could even be a boycott over this issue. And already there's a boycott over the Carolina law.
Financial bigotry and financial extortion, mafia-esque, it will never fly in terms of somebody's civil rights, and
Sam.
That's exactly
well, what I hope that community votes. I hope that community keeps agitating.
This comes down to I'm going to crush your business if you don't do what I say.
$329 million so far, Bruce Springsteen pulled out. I mean, everyone over this law?
Yes. Yeah. Keep breaking them. Don't give them your dollar.
This is Al Sharpton, Jesse Jackson playbook. You give us dough or else we're going to tell people that you don't like our community.
Okay,
and they're doing the same thing in reverse. This is financial racism.
He cost his state $60 million with laws just like this in Indiana. So it did work because he did eventually
reverse
position.
And I can't believe Pence buckled under that pressure, man. You know, the time it used to be, and I hope it comes back, when somebody could say, you know, I don't want to sell you a donut and it doesn't matter whether you do or not. Go to the next donut shop.
I wonder how much they charge for 60 seconds on his radio show. He's not getting much, I guarantee you.
No, I have to do that.
Everything. Because the dollar determines the flow of politics and everything else in this nation. You stop the flow of dollars if you want to alter politics.
No, please. Not with extortion.
Well, that is the way. Well, it's working, though, isn't it? It's what you vote with your
pocketbook.
This
is what Van Jones did to Glenn Beck, and he got him kicked off two networks around this.
So if
you
tell
lies about
you.
Don't forget Don Imus.
Yeah,
another one of your buddies.
The whole thing is intimidation.
Sam, let me just follow up a little bit what you said. Dollars moves this country along. If Hillary Clinton is taking dollars from corporate donors and Donald Trump is not, does that mean that Hillary Clinton owes something to the corporations?
Yes.
Supporting her?
Yes.
So yes. How can we get a fair? Then you're saying Donald Trump that doesn't
take
that. So
what you're
so like completely
weird,
what you're saying.
Charlie, that's what the WikiLeaks piece is.
So only the very rich will ever be able to run for president.
Here's what I'm concerned about. Hillary Clinton's taking dough from Arab countries through her Clinton Foundation. She owes them more than she owes McDonald's. That scares me to death.
Especially when it's Big Mac time.
Okay, so let's talk about Bernie Sanders.
All right, let's
talk
about
Bernie
Sanders.
He has been saying for quite some time that this entire system was rigged. Now it does appear that there is documentation to back up what he's been saying all along. What do we suspect he'll do now at the convention?
20,000 emails leaked through WikiLeaks. And I say thank God for WikiLeaks. You know, all along, many of us have been saying that the Democratic Party was rigging the whole piece. You know, they wanted to swat Bernie away as a nuisance. But Bernie has won 22 states.
So does he endorse Hillary Clinton at this convention, or does he pull a Ted Cruz?
Well, first of all, I'm sure they're worried about the Ted Cruz syndrome when Bernie gets up to speak. Because if Bernie speaks truth to power, he can't help but call out the shenanigans of the DNC, Debbie Wasserman Schultz, and that's why she's not speaking
There's
now.
There's a bigger piece to this. There's
what
a bigger piece to this. With the Democrat Party, and in some senses the Republican Party as well, it's about the agenda. Hillary's almost emblematic to the agenda. So Bernie's going to fall right in line with the agenda, which is a pretty much one world progressive globalist world. They
love fest,
big
love
government,
fest.
big government.
So if you were advising Bernie Sanders, would you have him pull a Cruz or say no, let's unite behind Hillary Clinton, our nominee?
If I was advising Bernie, first of all, I'd have to probably be of that mind. Well, you know, maybe not. I would advise him to stand a third party.
Well,
I'd say go third party.
Well, that's so impractical. He couldn't get on the ballot number one in
the
states to win. And symbolic races like that are no good. We need to defeat Donald Trump at all costs.
Good luck.
I can't say that enough.
Yeah, but Sam, when you say the system is rigged, that's not helping the Hillary cause.
My buddy filmmaker Michael Moore, whom I've worked with for many decades now, Michael is predicting that Donald Trump is going to be the next president of the United States. And I having worked with him over the years, I am convinced that Michael is on to something there, because there's enough hate to go around.
Should Bernie say, should he fall in line with the party and support Hillary?
He has very little options. Mm-hmm. He can pull a quasi Cruz and kind of spank the party, and some of those folks might like that properly spanked, but the reality is that when we look at it, Bernie's options are very few. He is going to fall in line, but his supporters.
He's a good soldier.
His supporters.
Do you think those supporters will go to Trump? Will those supporters go to Trump?
Some are going to go to Trump. Many will go to Jill Stein, and some simply won't vote. That could be a factor in those states, those 64 electoral votes.
Let me say, you brought up the name of Michael Moore. Michael Moore is the Joseph Goebbels of the terminally stupid. So whatever he says, throw it out. But he's got a good point, because Trump is going to smoke this.
Did Ted Cruz kill his career by not endorsing
Trump? Yes, he did. Ted Cruz is gone. And Ted Cruz, I got to tell you, for the first time in my entire life, I put a bumper sticker on my car, and it was Ted Cruz. I took it off as soon as he came up with three different things. I don't go into it in detail, but he literally torpedoed himself on stage at the Fox Theater when he stood with Marco Rubio against Trump's stand on radical Islam.
Well, I thought it was the size of the hands thing there here in Detroit when they came up here.
That was
But Cruz did kill himself off, because no one in the Democrat and the Republican base is going to work with this guy again. No.
Did he know that going in, or did he think there would still be a base of people who are against Trump?
Cruz is in another universe, separate from the Republican Party and everyone else. It's Cruzverse, but it's not going to sell to the American
public. Here's the problem with Ted Cruz. Ted Cruz applies to the uber conservative, the people that consider themselves to be the purest of the purest conservative, and perfect is the enemy of good. Those people still never Trump are resonating, they're rotating around Ted Cruz like the earth around the sun, and it's gonna hurt the Trump campaign, but it ain't gonna kill it.
Oh, about a dozen of them are rotating around.
Probably not a big factor.
So which party can unify?
Not a factor.
Which party can unify?
Well, I think that we've got a situation where Donald and Hillary have found one another. They're the only people that could beat one another that's on the planet right now.
Yeah, a lot of negatives on each
that's
of them.
That's true.
All right, why don't we hold that thought right there? We want to hear from you. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to share your thoughts on the air. Let It Rip Weekend continues right after this.
Well, Well, welcome back. Now it's time for you to be a part of the discussion. Theron, first question to you. It says Sam is on point with regard to the status quo of the Democratic Party and the constant fleecing of the black vote.
Fleecing of the black vote by the Democrat Party? Absolutely, because as I said last time I was here, the Democrats have figured out rather than throw dogs and fire hoses on people, give them free stuff, so they are going to fleece the black vote.
All right, Sam, let me ask you this. Where were the Bushes, the McCains, Mitt Romneys when Trump was nominated? Because the old school is out, the new school is in, doesn't that help make a new Republican Party, Sam?
Well, first of all, the Bushes and others represented the status quo Republicans. They're out of touch with the Republican base right now, and they're getting what they deserve, Donald Trump and more Donald Trump. And it's going to get worse in years to come.
This question quickly for both of you. Sherman says Trump is a reality show star, not a president. A vote for him is going to set people of color back many, many years.
That's 100% wrong. You're going to see more support in the people of color community when they realize it's about jobs, and that's what Donald Trump's about, jobs.
You know, the ugly reality is that 7 or 8 years ago, 60% of Detroit children were living in poverty. Now, as we wrap up Barack Obama's term, 60% of Detroit children are still living in poverty. It's a myth about the great Detroit comeback, and this has been under Democratic Party leadership.
Amen.
And I am a supporter of the Democratic Party.
I see a lot of agreements over here. Sam Riddle, Theron.
Never thought would agree.
I never thought that.
We're all going to lunch after.
Theron X, thanks a lot. Last quick here. Bring the All-Star Game to Detroit. We can handle it. All right, go back.
That's it.
Let it rip.
To
Detroit.